Thank you. Congratulations to all of the graduates of the class of 2023.
We are so proud of you.
You did it.
This is a big milestone.
You guys have worked hard to get here, and I can't wait to see what you guys do from here on out. Congratulations.
Congratulations, graduates. I am so happy you've made it to the finish line.
All the late night studying, all the struggles that you went through have finally paid off, and you are here today graduating and continuing on to great success.
It takes a lot of patience and time and energy and dedication.
And now the world is yours and is waiting for you to make your difference in the world.
You all are going to do amazing things, whether you're going to transfer onto a university or whether you're headed into the workforce. Please don't be strangers and always think of us as your Vaquero family.
Congratulations, class of 2023. I'm looking forward to seeing you in the future and all the great things that you do.
It's hard work and I'm proud of you guys and can't wait to see what you're going to do in your career.
Ahoy, mateys. I want to wish you a happy graduation. Keep fighting the good fight.
On behalf of me and all of our other faculty members and coaches, I just want to congratulate you on coming this far. This is just the beginning. The world is your oyster. Go out and conquer it and always remember where you came from.
I'm really happy for you. I'm proud of you, but more importantly, I hope that you are proud of yourselves.
Congratulations, class of 2023. You earned it.
Congratulations and felicidades.
You got this.
Follow your dreams.
Go Vaqueros.
Go Vaqueros.
Go Vaqueros.
Go Vaqueros.
Go Vaqueros.
Go Vaqueros.
I wish you guys all the best.
Never give up.
Today is your day.
We are CAC.
Congratulations, graduates.
Best wishes.
Si se puede.
And remember, continue to soar. Thank you.
Please be seated. We acknowledge that our institution, Central Arizona College, occupies ancestral lands of the Hohokam, who lived and farmed along the Gila River Basin centuries ago. We thank the native communities and descendants of these indigenous peoples whose stewardship of the land and waterways allows us to be here now. The Total Oram Nation, Akchin Indian Community, San Carlos Apache Tribe, and the Gila River Indian Community. Yeah. which is comprised of the Akmil Odom and the Peeposh tribes. Indigenous people from other Native nations also reside in Pinal County and have made innumerable contributions to our region. Recognizing that this land acknowledgement alone is not enough, we are committed to supporting Native communities by learning about and promoting Indigenous histories, cultures, and values, creating critical environments where Native individuals and communities are welcomed and valued, and collaborating with Indigenous nations in this region to protect Native sovereignty, governance, and jurisdiction over the territories. We seek to understand the ancestry of this place and provide a decolonized educational environment in support of Indigenous people so that our actions support these communities. Aho. Now, will everyone please stand and remain standing for the posting of the colors, the national anthem, and the Pledge of Allegiance.
Please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated. Good evening and welcome. Please join me in thanking Casa Grande Union High School Marine Corps JROTC for the posting of colors, Central Arizona College student Bobby Davis for the national anthem, and CAC Governing Board President Evelyn Kasuga for the Pledge of Allegiance. And now, we get to hear from Bobby Davis again. So Bobby Davis will be joining us again singing Memories by Maroon 5 for your entertainment.
Thank you, guys.
Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, 'cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way, 'cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back you. There's a time that I remember when I did not know no pain. When I believed in forever and everything would stay the same. Now my heart feels like December when somebody say your name. 'Cause I can't reach out to call ya, but I know I will one day, yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, eh, eh. Everything will be alright, go raise a glass and say, eh. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, 'cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way, 'cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back you. Do 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 do. Memories bring back you. There's a time that I remember when I never felt so lost. When I felt all of the hatred was too powerful to stop. Now my heart feels like an ember, and it's lighting up the dark. I carry these torches for ya, that you know I'll never drop, yeah. Everybody hurts sometimes, everybody hurts someday, eh, eh. Everything will be alright, go raise a glass and say, eh. Here's to the ones that we got. Cheers to the wish you were here, but you're not, 'cause the drinks bring back all the memories of everything we've been through. Toast to the ones here today. Toast to the ones that we lost on the way, 'cause the drinks bring back all the memories. And the memories bring back you. Do 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 do.
Thank you, CAC. Thank you, everyone. Congratulations, graduates.
Wow, that was fabulous. How about one more round of applause for Bobby Davis? Thank you. Good evening, and thank you for joining us for CAC's 2023 commencement. I'm Dr. Jenny Cardenas, Vice President of Student Services. And as we begin tonight, I'd like to draw your attention to the designated remembrance chairs that are in each section. We are aware that there are family members and friends of our graduates, as well as Central Arizona College faculty and staff, who we've lost during this past year. Though they are not with us tonight, we hold them in our hearts as we celebrate the momentous achievements of our graduates. I would now like to introduce the platform guests, so please stand as I call your name. Dr. Jackie Elliott, President, CEO for CAC. Governing Board President Evelyn Kasuga. Governing Board members, Mr. Gilbert Lopez. Ms. Ruth Smith, and Mr. Jerry Walker. Dr. Tina Berry, Academic Dean of Nursing, Allied Health, and Skilled Trades. Dr. Lisa Hahn, Dean of Student Development. And Mrs. Michelle Young, Faculty Senate President and Professor of Communication Studies. Thank you. Please be seated. So our faculty marshals who led out our faculty and graduates in the processional, we'd like to recognize you tonight and thank you for the work that you've done. Would you please stand and be recognized if you're a faculty marshal? Thank you. Would the district administration please stand and be recognized? Thank you. Would members of the faculty and staff please stand and be recognized? Thank you. And most importantly, would the graduating class of 2023 please stand and be recognized? Congratulations. All right, please be seated. So the first of our student speakers that we have for tonight was nominated by Dr. Sandy Rath and selected as our first speaker this evening. Would Sevasti Sylvia please join me at the podium? Sevi Sylvia is an all-academic team gold scholar, an honor awarded to only the top-ranking students across the state, earning her full tuition at an Arizona public university. She has served as the Phi Theta Kappa chapter president for two terms and as the VP of the Southern District of Arizona on Phi Theta Kappa regional board for one term as well. Please help me in recognizing Sevi.
Good evening, Central Arizona College class of 2023. And congratulations on this amazing achievement. I think we can all agree it was a journey to get here, but in the words of Freddie Mercury, we are the champions, my friends. Before I begin my speech proper, I would first like to thank the faculty, staff, and administrators at CAC who made this event possible. I want to thank and congratulate not only you, graduates, but also the families and friends present who support us all in our academic endeavors. I would personally like to thank my professors, Phi Theta Kappa advisors, and especially Dr. Sandy Rath, who made my experience at CAC exceptional. Lastly, thank you, Mom, Dad, and the rest of my family. I finally made it. As we look forward to the summer and the many seasons beyond, I think there are a range of feelings to be had. Relief, for the realization that that one math test wasn't really that bad. Pride, for achieving something great. Or maybe even confusion, for what comes next. What comes after graduation? For some, it will be the workforce. For others, a long, well-deserved vacation. And for those of you like me, it will be transferring to university. Regardless of where you may be going, I want to tell you all about an important lesson I learned here at CAC, a lesson that applies to everyone here today. Wherever you go, and whatever you do, I hope you can commit yourself to being a lifelong learner. This commitment doesn't mean you need to keep going to college. Instead, it is a challenge to pursue your curiosities and passions, whatever form they may take. When I personally started taking classes at CAC, I wasn't exactly sure what I should study. My academic interests were exclusionary instead of inclusionary. At the time, I knew I didn't want to study calculus, but I didn't know an intercultural communications class would change my career trajectory into the field of diplomacy. It took me a couple of semesters to realize it was better to approach learning as inclusionary. Casting a wide net promised a bigger catch. I didn't know anything about newspaper reporting, so why not take a class and see if I could be a journalist? Ceramics has always interested me, so why not pursue that interest actively and enroll in a class? Assuming a curious perspective to learning helped me explore concepts and ideas I had never thought to investigate. I never knew, as a communications major, that macroeconomics would be a class I would thoroughly enjoy. But with a credit requirement and a curiosity, economics is now suddenly a subject I might minor in. From intercultural communications to economics and every subject in between, my time at CAC showed me the importance of being open to learning experiences outside of my immediate area of study. Latching onto curiosities and letting them guide me was the best thing I did at CAC. I plan to take this lesson of lifelong learning and the pursuit of curiosity with me after I walk away from this podium. I urge you all to do the same. One more thing I learned at CAC was during my time as a PTK member and later as the president of our chapter. I actually learned it right in the beginning. In the membership pledge, there is a line I think is of particular note. It goes, "I pledge to support my fellow members, and I promise to aid them in all worthy endeavors." I would like to think the pursuit of knowledge is a worthy endeavor. As fellow graduates, we all have our different passions. Our dedication to them and our dedication to our certificates or our degrees is why we are here today. So far, we have had aid from people in our lives to persist on our journey towards knowledge. Dedicated faculty member, family, and friends have all helped us in our worthy endeavor. This pledge of support goes beyond membership of Phi Theta Kappa. Now, graduates, it is our turn. As we look forward to the future, let's all promise to aid others in their worthy endeavors as well. CAC helped me realize learning is more than a means to an end. It is a means unto itself. Knowledge is a powerful tool that cannot be taken away from you. So, class of 2023, I encourage you to continue to seek out knowledge, commit to a lifetime of learning, and aid others in their worthy endeavors. Thank you to all, and congratulations on your academic achievement.
Sevi, on behalf of the Governing Board, the College Administration, faculty and staff, and the Class of 2023, please accept this commemorative gift. All right, well, our second student was nominated by Ms. Gail Nettles and selected as our speaker for this evening as well. Would Fabian Gutierrez please join me at the podium? Fabian served as a 2022 TRIO peer mentor, bridge mentor for the coming CAC students. During the 2022-23 academic year, he was an office assistant to the TRIO program. We're here at CAC and plans to transfer to ASU Polytechnic in the fall. While focusing on his academics, he also went above and beyond to give back to the community by volunteering as a TRIO Student Support Services student with St. Mary's Food Bank and as a member of the Christian Challenge Club, serving as a volunteer for Feed My Starving Children. Please help me welcome Fabian.
Good evening and congratulations to the class of 2023. I'm going to start right off with a time of gratitude to my dearest friends and to my family. Thank you for always motivating and inspiring me, and thank you for always being a strong pillar of support for me. And to the TRIO team, thank you for all that you do to help first generation students such as myself navigate through our college experiences and providing a strong community to help us on the path. And to all of CAC staff and faculty, thank you for all of your hard work and dedication to get us all to where we are tonight. Now, I want to talk about perseverance in the face of uncertainty. In March 2020, I was a freshman here at CAC and was still very new into the college experience. And when that fateful day came, just before our spring break, I remember telling my friends, "I'll see you guys in just a few weeks." At that time, I had expectations of coming back in a few weeks and actually seeing them. And at that time, I had expectations also of getting a student campus job here. And I had expectations of finishing my education with CAC by 2021 or 22 at the latest. Now, none of that happened the way that I first envisioned it. I wouldn't actually see most of my friends for well over a year, and I didn't know when the next time it would be that I would see them again. I didn't get the on-campus job that I was looking for at that time, but good things came too, as I fell in love with shapes, colors, and design, and with that I changed my degree to digital media arts. My expectations of what was supposed to be were thrown out the window, and those were just a few to name. Now, each and every single one of you here, you too had your own plans. You too had your own expectations on how things were originally supposed to go. But nobody could have prepared for the challenges we were about to face. Whatever we planned for at that time, whatever we envisioned for that time, had to change, and we had to adapt to our newfound circumstances, uncertainty that has never been faced on such a scale in today's time. And within that, we may have faced additional challenges on top of everything that I was already coming with the pandemic. We may have changed our pace of things, changed places entirely, found new passions, discovered new interests. And you know what? We faced that uncertainty, the unknowns. We braved through the uncharted waters, and we persevered. We get to celebrate that here and now. It took me a little bit longer, but I made it here tonight. And you too experienced your journey, and you too get to celebrate tonight. My friends and family are here among the crowd, and during my time here, during my last few semesters, I've had the pleasure to work with Trio as a student worker there. So eventually getting that on-campus job as a student worked out too. I made it, and so did you. Now let us remember our perseverance in the face of such grand uncertainty as we move on to the next thing. Wherever you're headed in the next chapter, whenever the story gives you an unexpected twist or turn, remember that you triumphed over uncertainty before, and you will triumph again. But for tonight, let us celebrate with our friends, with our families, and let us also remember and honor our loved ones who cannot join us here tonight. Thank you so much, everyone. It has been an honor to speak with you. Congratulations, class of 2023.
Nice job. Thank you so much for your motivating words tonight. Congratulations. All right, our next student was nominated by Dr. Sandy Rath as well and selected as our third speaker for tonight. Would Robert Serrano please join me at the podium? Robert is also an all-academic team scholar, an honor awarding him full tuition upon transfer to Arizona State University's Barrett Honors Program starting in the fall. He has served as the Phi Theta Kappa Chapter Vice President of College Projects, and he recently earned a summer research position with the University of Massachusetts Research for Undergrads program. Please help me welcome Robert.
Graduates and honored guests, good evening and welcome to this special occasion. It's an honor to stand here today among my fellow graduates to celebrate our achievements and the start of a new chapter in our lives. That being said, I'm glad you all got the invite for this evening. If it had gone out on Blackboard, we probably all would have missed it. I would like to start this evening by thanking all the faculty and staff who helped get me here today. They are what really make a community college feel like a community. I would like to extend special gratitude to the entire STEM faculty, as well as our amazing Phi Theta Kappa chapter, Alpha Theta Delta, where I have met some of the most inspiring people I have ever known. My path to this point has been a bit unorthodox. In fact, it may surprise you to learn that this is the first graduation I have ever attended. When I moved to Arizona just before turning 18, I began feverishly applying to jobs. After hundreds of applications, I kept being denied, but unsurprisingly, they never told me why. With the help of an acquaintance, I finally landed a job. I was ecstatic, but there was a catch. The employer needed some proof that I completed high school. For most people, this wouldn't be an issue. While I was homeschooled, to say the curriculum was subpar would be an understatement. In reality, one could say I was unschooled, a term I only recently learned myself. It was only after losing that opportunity that I figured out I was unhirable, as I did not have a high school diploma. I was devastated. While I had thought about getting my GED in the past and even purchased the book, the 800-page behemoth was overwhelming, especially considering nearly half of it was math, something I thought was my weakest subject. The same person who helped me get that interview offered to tutor me so I could get my GED. In Arizona, the GED is broken into five tests: English, social studies, civics, math, and science. I passed the first three and was gearing up to tackle the monster that is math when we took a break for the holidays. Unfortunately, unfolding life events meant my friend could no longer tutor me. Then, COVID hit. Testing centers were closed, so even if I had wanted to study, I couldn't take the test. I took the rest of the year to finish studying, and thanks to online proctoring, I got my GED in just 16 months at the end of 2020. Still in the thick of the pandemic, I began to think about what I was going to do next. I'd always aspired to attend college, even when I was a child. I had no idea what I wanted to study. I could not explain why exactly school was important. I just knew I wanted to be the first in my family to go to college. After I was pulled out of public school, I felt like I would never get to fulfill that dream. Naysayers who I thought loved me filled my head with lies about how I would never make it. My father insisted I was going to become a semi-truck driver, and I didn't have a choice. While it is a noble and essential profession, I knew it's not what I wanted for myself. While there were GED testing centers closer to Phoenix, I didn't want to contend with the stress of making that drive just before a test. My friend then recommended taking it at CAC's Signal Peak campus, one of only a few GED-approved testing centers in Pinal County. I took those tests right over there, in the Learning Center. Little did I know that one decision would change the course of my life. When the college learned I had passed my GED, I received a letter from them. In it, the college extended an offer for a one-semester scholarship in recognition of obtaining my GED. I was hesitant at first and almost didn't accept it. I didn't think I could succeed, that my time had passed, and that there was no point in returning to school. I waited until the very last week to accept the offer, and I only did so because of the support of my grandmother and my best friend. Without them, I would not have accepted that offer. Without their support, I would have dropped out in the first semester because I was so stressed. Without them, I would not be here today. Last month, I spoke with someone very wise. We discussed how, as humans, it is easy to cling to the negative insults that people hurl at us, but nearly impossible to take compliments. I am no exception to this. I look back and I realize that for too long, I let the naysayers take too much of my life and hold me back. Over the last 2 years, I went from trying to prove to myself that I was worthy to now proving they were wrong. I stand here before you today ready to take the next step in my life and academic career. A week ago today, I received notification I was selected as a Jack Kent Cook Scholar, which is tied with obtaining my diploma tonight as my proudest achievement. If you had told me 2 years ago I would be graduating with an associate's degree and a full ride scholarship, I would have never believed it. Central Arizona College, along with my grandmother and best friend, brought my dream back to life and have given me the chance to build the life I want to live. It is with great pride that I say I will be attending Arizona State University this fall to complete my bachelor's degree in civil engineering. Before I depart, I want to share a quote I have come to live by. It was Harvey Milk who said, "I know you can't live on hope alone, but without hope, life is not worth living. So you, and you, and you, you have to give them hope." My hope is that my story gives you hope. Do not let others tell you who you're meant to be or what you're meant to do in life. When things get dark and you cannot see the light at the end of the tunnel, keep going. The opening is just around the bend. Now is your chance to make the future, to make the world's future. The sky is the limit. Don't settle. Thank you.
Thank you very much for your words tonight. Congratulations to you, and here is a commemorative gift as well. Thank you. All right, so in your program, you'll notice that we have one additional speaker, and the final speaker, Tyrese Johnson, was nominated by Professor Colette Dragan and selected to speak this evening. Unfortunately, he is unable to join us tonight as he has returned home to Canada while he determines his next educational steps. As an international student athlete, he navigated the transition of college life after coming to the desert to pursue baseball. In CAC classrooms, he was able to explore his academic development and bridge his experience into educational opportunities available to him. Earlier this week, Tyrese was presented with a commemorative gift for being selected as one of this year's speakers. Congratulations to Tyrese as well. And now I will invite Dr. Jackie Elliott, Central Arizona College President, to the podium to present the history of candidates.
Good evening. I would like to first tell you a little bit about the graduating class of 2023. There are 681 graduates this academic year, with a total of 828 degrees and certificates being awarded. Over the last 51 years, CAC has awarded a total of 27,747 degrees and certificates to over 251 individuals. The oldest person to be awarded a degree or certificate this year is 74. Good for you. And the youngest is 17. This evening we have 10 students who are graduating from high school and from Central Arizona College. In fact, they may be graduating from college first, since many of the high school graduation ceremonies are not until later this month. These students have earned 3 associate's degrees and 7 certificates. If there are students in the audience who are also graduating from high school, would you please stand and be recognized? Congratulations, you may be seated. I now invite Professor Michelle Young, Faculty Senate President, to the podium to do the presentation of candidates.
Good evening. I would like to now present the candidates for degrees and certificates, members of the governing board, college community, graduating students, family, and friends. On behalf of the faculty, I am proud to present the degree and certificate candidates from Central Arizona College. These candidates have distinguished themselves by successfully completing all prescribed requirements for the Associate of Arts, Business, Science, Applied Science, and General Studies degrees or certificate programs. At this time, I would like to welcome Governing Board Member President Evelyn Kasuga back to the podium to present the degrees and certificates.
Great. Thank you, Michelle. On behalf of the Board of Governors of Central Arizona College, and on recommendation of the faculty, I am pleased to present to each individual, as his or her name is announced, the appropriate associate degree or certificate with all the rights, privileges, and honors pertaining thereto. Candidates, please come forward as your name is read.
Second.
Madison Ford. Briley Hoyt. Sevasti Sylvia. Robert Serrano. Callie Johnson. Rachel Luna. Austin Bohana. Jasmine Salcido. Bobby Davis. Melissa Corral. Heather Weaver. Nina Valdenegro. Alexander Church. Tatum Church. Carlos Ruiz. Cheyenne Print. Ernest Coleman. Claudia Arroyo. Ralph Rosales. Brianna Anthony. Anna Maria Dennis. Tiana Jimenez. Anthony Ramirez Madrid. Alexis Arroyo. Casey Lopez Delgado. Yeah.
Donna Courtney. Michaela Cioni. Georgia Schuster. Dana Marie Conway. Layla Hamlin. Ashley Bartman Hamlin. Fabian Ignacio Gutierrez.
You did it. You got it. You're doing it good.
Chiffon Davis. Jessica Gavin. Michael Boltwright. Kaylee Yon. Destiny Leanne Lipkin. Joshua Rodriguez. Jennifer Maxey. Layla Roach. Brianna Bermia. Sonia Medina. Adriana López Bejar. Carol Ramos. Edith López. Jeanette Rubacarba. Annette Arochi. Magda Ruiz. Carmen Coronel. Aide García. Julia Mendez. Ana Laura González. Priscilla Frimbres. Abdulia Prado Sandoval.
Elsa Yáñez Ochoa. Jessica Boyce. Rosana Jimenez. Maria Teresa Garcia. Elizabeth Martinez. Rosalia Luzan. Rocío Arvizu. Catalina Borboa. María Pérez. Maya Pérez. Chelsea Vega López. Madison Placencio. Itzel Ariel Espinosa. Aurora Ramírez. Lía Salcido. Esmeralda Alvarado Rivera. Haley Marshall. Lillian Medrano. Amaya Carissa Duran. Victoria Salamanca. Mariela Martinez. Alana Maya Carrasco. Gianna Ramirez. Xavier Bailey. Dusky Poti. Jeanette Rivera. Andres Quiroz. Cristina Raquel Fierro. Ruth Mounts. Cedric Smith. Marina Leon. Laura Detour. Rosa Elena Lopez. Rosa Lopez. Andrea Provencio. Jasmine Campuzano. Amanda Garfield. Sophia Edwards. Cassandra Tagan. Kyle Kramer.
Let's get it.
Otto Abbott. Sarah Horn.
Yeah.
Mia War.
Hi, Mia.
Dorothy Louise Johnson. Shay Williamson. Mariah Cavazos. Mindy Ramirez. Kayla Olawine.
Yeah! Oh yeah, Kayla!
Kayla Bacani.
Yeah.
Michaela Cousins.
Yeah.
Riley Webb.
Yeah.
David Ortiz. Jimmy Hopper. Timothy McBride. Blake Avila. Cam Dimos. Desiree Borrego. Adrian Thomas. Logan Duran. Maila Gaddi. Bailey Martinez. Lucas Adams. Kennedy Simone Patrick. Angel Honeybone. Kamani Bledsoe. Miracle Brown Jeter. Gabriel Ramirez. Aiden Corey. Hayden Ramirez. Kyle Morris. Mario Castañeda. Jennifer Lopez Martinez. Isalena Gary. Don Grace the Third. Kinley Hall. Jake Valdez. Jazimir Santiana. Bailey Lindsay. Donna Renee Madden. Samantha Hoy. Christopher Mendoza. Riley McFarland. Colton Larson. Luke Franz Fogg. Zachary Rodriguez. Dylan Whitmer. Timothy Jaramillo. Julie Jaramillo. Natasha Roseberry. Renee Wilson. Norma Hernandez. Adam Bowman. Santiago Arias.
Lisbeth Porras Garcia. Crystal Delgadillo. Deborah Lawless. Michelle Villa. Nasia Brown. Jocelyn Saavedra. Christy Little. Claudia Lopez. Nick Rodriguez. Peyton Maturo. Zachary Heerman. Heather Torres. Mia Little. Kathy Mahaney Allen. Chloe Anna Collins. Tatum Ronquillo. Kira Schirmeyer. Cameron Nelson. Noah Joaquin Olmos. Jose Perez. Danielle McDonald. Veronica Walker. Jaden Brown. Elazar Getahun. Joseph Maher. April Hall. Denise Vasquez. Nayari Itzera Tadeo. Danielle Garcia. Michaela Marie Garcia. Montserrat Gonzalez. Jennifer Martinez. Yeah.
Hendricks. Isben Cebreros Lopez. Isael Ortiz. Nadine Balkowski. Emily Liverman. Zachary Woods. Jorge Angulo. Alejandro Bautista. Andres Bautista. Eduardo Uribe. Kara Tao. Mark Anthony Aragon. Aaron O'Hare. Elizabeth Miller. Christy Hill. Alicia Scholl. Jennifer Tyson. Stephanie Barron. Hetsamani Uriate. Amanda Saunders. Luz Montoya. Janessa Janelle Galvan. Lucas Edgewater. Ka'ahu Ha'aliliu. Colton Gwen. Brad Moreno. Kirsten Pettis. Jessica Tai. Lauren Allen. Tanya Egino Martinez. Lisbeth Vargas. Yeah.
Isaac Herrera. Ryan Klingsmith. Fernando Perez. Brian Petersham. Hannah Paul Gindiri. Cleo Glass III. Brooke Lynn McDermott. Brianna Marie McDermott. Victoria Alvarado. Victoria Hernandez. Michaela Sanchez. Yadira Rodriguez Murillo. Matthew Paraíso. Isaac Lupi. Tiffany Reed. Anthony Saldaño. Kaylee Guy. Heidi Escalante Calderón. Alexandra Moraga. Jasmine Vasquez. Brianna Adams. Leah Martin.
Martin Del Campo. Christina.
Christina Marin Del Campo. Claudia Rogers. Devin Venditti. Carlo Hosky. Gabrielle Lara. Adrian Moreno. Viviana Flores. Paola Carter. Jocelyn Rubio Fajardo.
Emily Thompson. Ashley Brown. Johnny Valenzuela Jimenez III. Donette Heath. Barbara Ann Wallman. Joseph Thalman. Mackenzie Miranda. Jasmine Varela Pinuelas. Ashlyn Pierce. Betty Chumbre. Chanel Nelson. Carmen Venegas. Kimberly Mercado. Stephanie Berraza. Delia Heeswick, Van Heeswick. Krista Rolf. David Alderete. Gabriel Croft. Jesus Gallegos. Jesus Gallegos. Jesus Gallegos. Israel Yanez Sanchez. Makai Height. Kimberly Miller. Alisa Savala. Albert Gonzalez Jr. Jared Kaufman. Jeanette Cabral. Michael Marcus. Samantha Rusol. Infinity Salomons. Alexander Osorio. Carlo Hernandez.
Tahani Cepeda. Rita April Mendeville. Allison Briggs. LaQuisha Knighton. Donald Tolliver. Austin Galindo. Cesar Luna. Jacqueline Valencia Anaya. Sanaya Jones. Giovanna Cornett. Zamisha Mile. Nicole Fiala.
Before our closing remarks, I'd like to share some information with everyone. There will be two exit points following the ceremony. Signs will direct traffic in the direction of either Coolidge, using the exit you use to enter campus, or Casa Grande, using the main college exit. Please remain in your seats until all graduates have exited. And now, will all graduates please rise? At this time, please transfer your tassel from right to left to symbolize your momentous accomplishment as a college graduate. Congratulations, another round of applause. This concludes the 2023 Central Arizona College commencement. Thank you for joining us tonight. As a reminder, please remain in your seats and allow the graduates to exit. Thank you.